Coach will let you open up with a few remarks and we'll take some questions.
We're a better basketball team than we were a couple weeks ago. I think our guys are locked in and made some progress defensively. And we knew the focus tonight was second chance points for LSU, keeping them off the boards, and we did a lot. Didn't do a very good job of that, and they did a great job. A lack of physicality, it was a factor, but give LSU all the credit. They know who they are, and they just threw us out of the way and killed us on the boards with 29 second chance points in a 5-point game. We knew we had to spread them and shoot them, and I thought we did a pretty good job with that. Even shooting, making 16, shooting 42%, I thought we left several out there, a lot of good looks. LSU turned us over in the first half. Obviously, Waters, they had 12 steals. Give them all the credit. They were scrappy, and we did not take care of the basketball. So you kind of add it all up. And can't go on the road and be the national ranked team when you make that many, have that many mistakes. I thought Jared Harper and the matchup with him and Waters was terrific. Jared's obviously excited about playing, and I thought that the combination of Jared and Bryce defensively was pretty good. Waters is he's a tough cover. The matchup between Okiki and Naz Reid was a great matchup. They both finished with double doubles. So. You had to be entertained. I would think.
If you have a question, Coach, raise your hand. We'll get a mic to you.
This summer, you called Coach Wade one of the toughest scouts that you've been around. What is it? What did you see? I guess going into this game, and then how did it compare?
He puts the guys in the right spots. They got good spacing. He understands the strengths and weaknesses of his personnel. And he's able to adjust. He's got a great offensive mind. And I think that's a great separator. And then I think he's got a terrific staff. I think LSU staff and my staff are two of the better staffs in the league. I think a lot of respect. I say that about Coach Wade at times because when I was out of coaching, I was working for ESPN. I actually saw Will's teams play at Chattanooga. I had a former assistant of mine, Brooke Savage, that was working for Coach Wade at Chattanooga. And I went and visited their practice just to try to get better myself, being out. And so Will was like, "You're Bruce Pearl and you were at Tennessee. I'm Will Wade and I'm at Chattanooga. What are you doing here?" So he was very humble. At the same time, if you all know me, I'm beyond humble myself. I'm like, "Dude, I am nobody from nowhere. You do a great job, and I just want to watch you practice and learn." So if he felt that was a compliment, great. That's not what it was intended. I was trying to get better, and I was witnessing a really good young coach. And spent a couple of days there.
Coach, you shot the ball so incredibly well in the first half. Did you have a feeling it was going to be hard to maintain that? In other areas of the game in the second half?
We didn't shoot as well in the second half. We took better care of the ball, but we didn't execute shoot as well. LSU made some, they extended a little bit more. We made 11 threes in the first half. They just had to get out and extend a little bit, rather than catch a little bit sooner. They did a good job in their game plan, do the best they could to take away Bryce, to really make it difficult for us to get Bryce the ball. Nice looks, so on and so forth. So.
One right here.
Coach, what is it with LSU that's so good for them with rebound the ball offensively?
And running underneath. They just got great size down there. They got two monsters down there. And we didn't want to give up pressure and take one of our bigs off the ball, so we try to keep a big on the ball. They anticipated that, and they got us on the inside. times, but at the same time, our guards got, all you got to do is stay between. Like, they didn't lob it to him. They threw it right through us. I promise you, I could not defend him on the lob. But I promise you, I could stay between him and the ball. And we did not.
Brad?
Bruce, were you aware you were out of the box when you called the tender call? You seemed a little surprised. No.
I was not protesting a call. I was a foot out of the box. I had been warned. I ruled. I was out of the box.
One more, Jock.
Coach, despite everything, you were right there at the end. Can you just describe what you saw from your perspective? You know, get the shot there.
I got to look at the last play, see when Bryce Brown got hit. If he did, he did. I got to go look at it, so we'll see. I liked when the kids kept competing and fought through some adversity. But we did not get the job done.
Thanks, Coach.